Welcome back to Strictly Politics. The hostage drama in Agusan del Sur enters day five with 12 more captives still in the hands of their abductors. What are local officials doing to secure the release of these hostages? And what are they doing to resolve the issue of private armies in the south? Joining us to talk about this is Senior Superintendent Nestor Fajura. He's the spokesperson of the Crisis Management Committee, the local Crisis Management Committee in that province. Good evening, Colonel Fajura. Thank you for joining us, sir.
Good evening, ma'am. Thank you very much for inviting us into your program.
Of course.
Good morning also to all your listeners, please.
Yes, sir. Well, sir, let's begin with this before I go into my questions. You just came from a meeting of the Crisis Management Committee. Can you tell us what is the latest?
The latest so far is that we are exploring now more seriously the recommendation of the legal task group who were tasked to study the legalities behind the requests of the hostage taker to release Ondo Perez.
Okay, so, and the recommendation of this task group that is that studied yung mga legalities ng request or demand ng grupo?
Yes.
What is that recommendation, sir? Can you tell us what that recommendation is first?
The recommendation is that it would still be within the parameter of our legal frameworks, and that things would just be expedited, because we found out now that aside from the cases here in Agusan del Sur, there are still other cases filed in other provinces involving Mr. Ondo Perez.
Ah, okay. Sir, sige, I'll get to that in a while, no? So, the yung legality, yung request ng grupo is to drop all the cases against him. Ganun po ba?
It is not to drop the case, but to release him from jail. The demand really is to release him from jail, and of course that means that all cases against him will be dropped or maybe dismissed or whatever. But at this point in time, with the gravity of the offenses charged against Ondo, plus there's so many other charges that were filed in different places, it's really, really very hard as of now to give in to the request that he will be brought out of jail.
Okay, but he is in jail right now, sir, because of which case? Is it the multiple murder case or the more recent hostaging of 75?
The initial jailing of Mr. Ondo Perez here at Agusan del Sur is mainly due to the multiple murder.
Okay, and that multiple murder case happened when, sir?
It happened way before the Maitom hostage-taking incident.
Several years ago, sir?
Maybe a year ago. Maybe a year ago before that Maitom hostage-taking incident.
Ah, okay. Of course, people are wondering, no, kung may kaso na siya at nasa jail siya, paano pa siya nakakagawa ng krimen?
Basically, the Maitom hostage-taking is... before that, there was the multiple murder case. So, supposedly, the warrant of arrest cannot be served to him because he is at large and he is armed, and he had been transferring from one place to another. Mm-hmm. However, in one of the instances wherein we have some patrol people going around Maitom, his group was spotted, not necessarily to serve his warrant of arrest, but Ondo Perez thought all the while that the government troops at the area, which are conducting prophylactic patrol, was meant to serve his warrant of arrest. That is the reason why he held hostage 75 people so that he will not be taken into custody.
Okay, sir, a very basic question first, no? Who is this Ondo Perez, and why is he able to wreak havoc in Agusan del Sur?
This Ondo Perez is a member, one of the leaders, known leaders of our indigenous people here at Agusan del Sur. He has his own group, and we came to know that there were some conflicts between some tribe with another tribe emanating from boundaries or petty crimes or robberies that happened in between different tribes until it went out of hand, and since they are armed, the killing started.
Tribe, sir. Ano to? Yung Manobo?
Yes.
Okay. Of course, just because they are tribes, it doesn't mean that they should be armed, right, sir?
As far as we know, they used to be members of our CAFGU.
Uh-huh.
They used to be at the working for with the government, and they helped us in the problems with the New People's Army in the area before. And after some time, when our troops left them behind, I think as part of their protection, some firearms were also left behind.
Okay, so ex-Kafgu, Manobo tribe, quarrels with other tribes about boundaries, petty crimes, etc. Earlier, you also said that his group, he has a group, so he moves around Agusan Sur protected. Is his group on the private army list? There was a task force on private armies, a commission, the Zenia Rosa Commission. They came out with a long list of private armies. Private army po ba ang tawag dito? I mean, they're an armed group. They're not government, hindi po ba?
They used to be part of the CAFGU of the Philippine Army, and then so they were not classified them as private armed group until such time that they were involved in criminalities.
So are they classified now as a private army?
Yes.
So private army sila. So nasa listahan po ba sila ng Zenia Rosa Commission?
I think yes.
Aha, okay. So if they're a private army, then they should have been targeted for dissolution, or for the authorities to go after them.
Basically, recently they were dropped, I think, from the list because they were already placed in jail.
Uh-huh.
Remember, Pia, the current hostage negotiator are the younger sets. These are not the older ones. These are the younger sets already.
So, parang tumubo lang ng ano?
Yung mga matatanda na, yun na ngayon ang masakulungan.
Aha, okay. So, yung mga iniwan nilang mga kamag-anak nilang mga bata.
Siguro na ano, yun na ngayon ang ano, yun na ngayon ang nag-rise up because allegedly or according to them, they are still victim of other atrocities coming from other tribes and also victim of some injustices as they claim in the processing of the ancestral domain land nila.
So ancestral domain ngayon ang ginagamit
kasama
nilang issue.
Kasama po sa issue yan.
Kasama po sa issue.